Wedgwood. The very name has a ring to it. As far back as the late 1700s, this Staffordshire-made creamware was so renowned, royalty ate their dinner off it. But Josiah Wedgwood wanted his world-famous crockery to grace less regal tables too. Wedgwood's ambition had a very rocky ride. Only the clay from Cornwall gave him the creamy finish he needed. Oh, but the journey by plodding horse or mule, it was painfully slow. And, well, the finished wares, often they fared even worse on the road to market. Wedgwood's vision was to take his goods on a new, quicker route, by canal. In the mid-18th century, crockery was produced in small potteries dotted around the West Midlands. His Cornish china clay had to be shipped north to Liverpool before trundling by road down to Staffordshire. Josiah's solution would help spark the Industrial Revolution decades later. His plan transformed his industry and made him rich. Moving his raw materials by water at 30 tons a time made it quicker, cheaper, and the potteries could export their goods to the world in one piece with fewer breakages. The competition was literally barged away. In 1761, though, England's only canal was the Bridgewater out of Manchester. No use to Wedgwood down near Stoke. His proposed canal would link the rivers Trent and Mersey. But a rival navigation company on the nearby River Weaver objected. Wedgwood's new waterway would ruin their trade.
They'd been running in business by this time for 30 years, carrying maybe 20,000 tons a year, and they didn't want anybody to come along and take their business away from them.
To stymie Wedgwood's plans, his opponents dreamt up canal routes that bypassed the potteries altogether. So Josiah campaigned up and down England, bringing landowners and public on side. But before carving the second only canal through the country, they needed to get it through Parliament. In 1765, Charles Darwin's grandfather, Erasmus, helped draw up a campaign pamphlet.
Darwin could get a little bit sarcastic with his amendments. This is one typical Darwin-type comment. A very garrulous sentence, omit at least three lines. Very pedantic.
And this draft ends up as this weighty tome. This is what goes to the Houses of Parliament. With his arch rivals still calling the plans miserable and flimsy, Wedgwood nevertheless won the day. His canal bill made the statute book in July 1766. The Trent and Mersey Canal was opened to a fanfare here 5 years later, but that didn't stop Josiah jostling for advantage. To the infuriation of Pottery's rivals, he ensured that the canal was routed right past his new factory. And just to let everyone know he was truly home and dry, he built this grand house on the other side of the water. When Josiah died in 1795, he was worth a staggering £500,000, 30 million in today's money. He pioneered the Industrial Revolution, mechanized production, and put good crockery on the tables of the masses. The Wedgwood name stood alone for nearly two centuries before the business went into receivership in 2009 and was sold off. But today, travelers on the Trent Mersey can be grateful that Wedgwood finally got his way.
A story beautifully told, and we're now enjoying a very civilized cup of tea from Wedgwood.
And we should indeed raise our cups to Josiah Wedgwood, one of the great men of our country.
Cheers.
I mean, he was a social reformer.
He was.
He pioneered, as it were, the fight against slavery, for example. Yeah. And he was an industrial reformer, one of the fathers of the Industrial Revolution.
Yes.
A great man.
Wonderful at technology as well, which you're about to demonstrate.
This is something that he invented. What do you think this is?
Well, in the rehearsal, I did say it looked like a giant Kit Kat to go with it. It's not.
It's a pyrometer invented by Josiah Wedgwood to actually measure the temperature in a kiln. Until he invented this device, there was a character called a kiln man who stood by the kiln saying, yes, I think it's hot enough now to actually have baked the pottery. But sometimes he didn't get it right and the pottery was smashed. This device, in which, as it were, a little globule of the clay is put, and as you will have discovered, I'm sure in science at school, what happens to clay, as it gets hotter, it gets smaller, it contracts, and you can actually measure the temperature by the size of the pottery going down the clay as it went down these little rivulets here. And it's measured in what were known as Wedgwood grades, centigrade, Wedgwood grade.
Oh, right.
He invented this, and because of this, mass production became possible. It changed the world. And he gave us, of course, creamware that became popular because he sent some to Queen Charlotte, Queen of George III. She loved it, and she said, ooh, I like this. And because the Queen liked it, the middle classes began to adopt it. I'm handling this with care, only because that particular jug is worth some £4,000. The sauce boat, £2,000. I just hope we're insured.
But he could have actually touched that as well, couldn't he?
No, Josiah, this is, this is from the Wedgwood Museum. These items could have been touched
by Are you a fan of the creamware, Melanie? Do you like the creamware?
It's very beautiful, yes. I'm very nervous.
Do you have any Wedgwood in your house?
No, I don't think so.
You can take this vase.
I've got lots of IKEA and Habitat.
You're probably the only person at this table who could afford this vase.
Tell us about the vase.
This is made of jasper ware. And in 1774, after 1,000 experiments, Wedgwood came up with jasper ware, a new kind of, well, it was like porcelain, as subtle as porcelain, but actually sturdier. And he, because he was as modern as tomorrow, but had a lot of time for yesterday, this is a recreation of an old Etruscan vase. Actually, once Caesar Augustus had a vase like this. The British Museum had one, and he made a copy of it that would now retail for £100,000 if you could buy it. And in fact, when in the 1800s the British Museum one was broken, when it was broken, they used Wedgwood's model to recreate it.
Can I just point out Nigel here, who's from the museum, as Giles is waving his arms around, he's sweating and diving like a goalkeeper.
Nigel's over there, and the men in the white coats are over there. One's going to take that lot and the other's going to take me, but why not?
But you've bought another collector's item in it.
I have a collector's item for one of my heroines. I felt you needed to have a little bit of Wedgwood in your life, and so, Mel, look what I've got for you.
Oh, wow.
Your own Wedgwood plate.
Isn't that lovely?
Priced above rubies.
It's proper Wedgwood.
Proper Wedgwood.
Is it?
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
but you have got Wedgwood in your house now.
Made in...
This would cost you £12,000, and this certainly £1.20. Oh, well, no.
We are reliably informed it's worth £16.
Yeah.
There you go.
If it will increase, after the musical, it'll increase.
Brilliant. Wedgwood name lives on.
Okay. Perfect. Thanks so much, Jack.
Fabulous. Lovely.